Have you ever imagined if one day the electricity in your home suddenly black out, and then you call PLN asking them to send you their technical or engineer to solve the electrical issue at your home, and then suddenly the one who showed up in your home is a woman engineer? What will your reaction? Mau ngapain, Mbak? Ada yang bisa saya bantu? That's pathetic. But that's the reality, and that happened. So, I've been part of Schneider Electric since November 2015 as a field engineer. In my workplace, there were only 2 female engineers out of 30 engineers altogether. Every time I drop by the client site, on my first encounter, they have always asked me, "Are you alone? No other engineers with you?" And I was like, "No." So, it seems that this has been a somewhat acceptable reaction when a young female engineer come to your factory carrying electrical tools on hand and having determination to solve the various and challenging technical issue at your workplace. So here is the thing. There is a common stigma in our society that several jobs are only specifically suitable for men, and several jobs are only specifically suitable for women. This gender stereotyping revolving around women in competency technical skills still exists until this day. It happened to me. Truthfully, it was not easy at the first time, and never, never, never easy. It remains as an issue. So, technical skill is not the only thing that matters when we talk about gender stereotyping in engineering sector. Physical strength does matter. Working with medium voltage and low voltage equipment requires a healthy physique. As an example, I need to be in my best fit condition to operate all those cubicle, all those electrical panel. I need to be in my best fit condition to charging the circuit breaker or to just measure the capacitance. Can you imagine if I am not fit enough to operate all those electrical equipments? That situation would certainly put my life in danger. So, as an engineer, I need to put personal safety as my first priority. Interestingly, sometimes I come across to customer who neither have a technical or engineering background, and technical questions are compound. So trying to explain the technical dictionary to my client is just it's never an easy task. But I find it challenging, and I find a personal satisfaction because I need to combine not only my communication skills but also my technical skill, and it's so challenging. And in my company, my company put much attention on diversity and inclusion. My manager and my peers ensure me that I feel empowered in this male-dominated industry. This is only possible because of my company put much attention on diversity and inclusion. In global survey, 85% survey, the global talent leader and diversity agreed that the inclusive and diversity workplace could drive innovations. So, research has shown that innovative could be driven by diversity, by the gender diversity. Companies should work to expand their talent pool by looking beyond pure technology background. Women with different background, such as from law, from business, or from communication, absolutely can make progress, can make a career in technology industry. And some women tend to think that they need STEM education background to join the tech industry, while in fact, even if you didn't have a STEM in the STEM education background, you still can make a career in this technology industry. In BCG research, there are 3 main factors that could lead the gender imbalance in technology industry. The first one is the choice to pursue higher education in technology. So the lack of exposure for girls in high school about technology topics could be a challenge. And I think this is very important to expose children as early as possible to technology field so they can assess their personal interest without any expectations. The second factor is the selection of the first job. So there is the influential factor that shaping women's decision about their selection of the first job. It is the opportunity to follow their educational path, so which highlights the importance of attracting more girls to STEM industry to pursue higher education in technology. And then another factor is the competitive payment and benefits, as well as the personal interest. And the last factors that could trigger the gender imbalance in tech industry is the choice to stay in the technology industry over a long term. So the mainly cause of this factor is the compensation and the attractive of career opportunity, as well as the work-life balance. So women who have these points, they tend to stay in their job better than the one who doesn't have this point. Technology can be a powerful lighthouse for change. And currently, people are increasingly conscious about the gender imbalance in technology industry. And this needs to be solved. But this cannot be solved without the coordinated multi-stakeholders between schools, government, companies, and the women themselves. And I'm gonna make a highlight with this last point, which is the women themselves. So actually, women has a personal responsibility. Women, especially women in tech industry, has a personal responsibility in order to help drive this change. And if I can make a point, there are three key priorities for women. The first one is develop both hard skills and soft skills. So women needs to define what success means for them. And they need to be proactive in building the right skill set that can provide their own career development goals. So women need to connect outside their role and outside their company in order to get this opportunity. So the second one is the find the right mentor. If I think of people who achieve success in their life, I know that there is a mentor or a coach along the way. And to achieve success through positive mentoring or coaching, we must first be willing to open our mind to receive the coaching. And by having a coach or a mentor, I believe that it will help us to build daily adversities into a successful habits. The last point is learn every day. To stop learning is to stop growing. There's no such thing as knowing it all or having all the answers, because we never will be. We never have all the answers, and there's no such thing as enough. No. We believe in lifelong learning. So every day and every minute, there is a chance to listen, to open up our minds, to expand our horizons. So these three key priorities is really important for women in tech industry to help overcome this gender imbalance issue in technology industry. So being a female engineer had been tough at times. And even though I am in a minority situation and breaking the stereotypes, I have no absolute regret on choosing this career path. I believe that women and men can be equally succeed. So let's last but not least, remember, anytime, whenever you have an electrical issue in your place, in your company, in your factory, if there is a woman who come to your place trying to solve your issue, but please do respect her and do appreciate her.